Hello everyone. Now we are going to see something about 3 Days to See by Helen Keller. Helen Keller is an American woman. She fell ill and became deaf and blind at the age of 19 months. In spite of his handicap, she graduated from Radcliffe College. She met the teacher Mrs. Annie Sullivan. 3 Days to See is a moving and touching piece of writing in which the deep feeling of a handicapped woman have been expressed frankly. The feeling expressed in it come out of a sense of value of physical facility which ensures full life. Helen Keller rightly points out that normal people don't realize the value of sense. In the 3 Days to See, Helen Keller tells us her plan of 3 imaginary days of sights. On the first day, she tells us that she would rise very early in the morning and would see the dawn. She would see the miracle of coming of the day from night. She would like to see her teacher, Mrs. Annie Sullivan's face for a long time. She had been her great benefactor. Then she would see the trifle of her house, they convert a house into home. She would also like to see the faces of her friends and dog. At night, she would go to some theater to watch Shakespeare's play. And on her imaginary second day of sight, she would like to see the world's present and past as expressed in the form of art. She would visit the Metropolitan Museum of Art and New York Museum of Science. She would also see the spirit of Rome, Greece and Egypt as expressed in the masterpieces of art. She would see the sculptures, God and goddesses. She would see the wrinkled faces of Homer, who was also blind. In the evening of the second day, she would enjoy some comedy plays at theater. The third day would be spent in seeing the ordinary sight of people. She would go to the slum, park and factories. She would begin her visit from the suburb to her residence. She would visit the East River, where she would enjoy the panorama of the ships and boats coming here and there. She would enjoy the lazy structure of steel on the bank of the river. She would see buildings of New York, which had come down from the pages of some fairy stories. She would visit the common places and would know about ordinary life of the people. In the evening, she would enjoy the play. The night would replace her to eternal blindness. She had left a lot which could not be seen. While concluding this, Helen Keller is of the view that eyes are the windows of soul. We should use our eyes not for convincing but for adding fullness to life. We should use our eyes as if we would be seeking blind tomorrow. We should use our sense in the same manner as we would lose them the next day. She further says that she would devise a subject for using eyes. If she were the president of university, the professor would teach you the correct use of eyes. She was a gifted woman who had exceptional writing ability, and she utilized simplistic style to correspond with all varieties of people. She wrote to inspire people and to help disabled people achieve their goals.